quick and rapid demo of Libib Pro. And I've already created a Libib Pro account, so I'm just going to go ahead and log in and get started. When you first log in, you're essentially going to be greeted with this blank screen. And before you can start adding items or really doing anything with the site, you want to add what's called a collection. And a collection is just a name for a group of your items. And every account can have up to 100 collections. I'm going to title this collection My Books. The language is the predominant language of the items that you're adding. This just helps with sorting, is all this does, so that it will sort correctly according to the rules of that language. Let's go ahead and add that collection. Once that's added, I can either add more collections, or I'm going to go back to the main library page. You can see in this drop-down menu at the top the list of my collections here. I only have one collection so far, My Books, and there are zero items in this collection. So let's go ahead and start adding items. There's a bunch of ways to add items. You can search for an item using its ISBN or the LCCN or a keyword. You can do a manual entry, or you can do a CSV import. First, let's go ahead and just do an ISBN lookup. So I'm going to be looking for a book. This is the ISBN of that book. I'm going to search for that book. And when I search by ISBN, it just automatically adds it to my library. So now again, if I go back to the library page, in my books collection, I have one item now, and it is that ISBN book that I just added. If I click on it, it's going to list all the item details that Libib tries to bring in automatically for you. And in here, I also have a few other options. As a pro user, I can edit all these different details. I have catalog information that I can edit, and there's additional information like tags and groups and notes. I'm going to add a graphic novel as a tag to this. And this becomes a searchable tag as well. So I'm going to go ahead and escape out of here, and that just closes it. And when I added that tag, that creates a filter option. And if I select that filter, it'll bring back everything that's tagged with graphic novel. In this case, just the one item. So I'm going to go ahead and close out my filters. And let's go ahead and add some more items, but let's do it with a CSV import this time. Let's do this book import file. I'm going to click upload. From here, really the most important thing is that you have an EAN, ISBN 13, or a ISBN 10, or UPC if it's like movies. This is what Libib has to have in order to import the item. This is what it uses. I'm just going to go ahead and process this import. While this import is processing, let's go back to the library, and we should see these items getting added. Where I had one item before, now I have five. If I refresh, it should start adding up 9, and you can see these items are being added as they are being cycled through. Let's go and take a look at managers. A manager is an additional user that we want to help manage this library. In this case, I'm going to just add a manager here. And then there's a bunch of roles that we can assign to them. An admin is essentially they have access to everything except billing and adding more managers. But they can access all your collections. They can add and remove stuff. They can restore things. They can go into your settings. So they're basically an admin with the exception of they can't interact with billing or add more managers. A manager is someone who you assign specific collections to. So let's say you are a principal and you want each teacher to have their own collection that they are responsible for their classroom library. You would assign them as a manager, create that collection for them, and then assign that collection to that manager. And then finally, we have a lender, and a lender is someone whose sole responsibility is to lend out items. They can't add or delete items. They can lend out items and edit and delete and add patrons because they need that responsibility in order to lend, but they don't have any editing responsibilities across the different collections or items. In this case, I'm going to add Jason as a manager. Once they've been added, they'll show up at the bottom here. I'm going to minimize that so we can see it. If they logged in right now as this person, as this email, they wouldn't have access to anything. It would just tell them your account doesn't have access to any collections. So we actually need to add a collection first. My books is the only collection I have, so I'm going to add them to that collection. So now they have the ability to manage this specific collection. If I had more collections, I could add additional collections for them to manage as well if I wanted. So we've added that manager. Let's go to lending. Lending is a way that we can set up patrons and we can check items out or place items on hold for patrons. Before I lend out item, let's just go ahead and add a patron. Oh, in this case, I think I'd previously added this patron. This is Scott. He's been added. So let me go ahead and add another patron. The only required fields are first and last name. You don't need any other fields to add a patron. However, adding an email will allow the patron to receive email notifications or to log in on a published site, which gives them a few more options. So in this case, I'm just going to leave the first and last name and I'm going to add this patron. And then if I go back to view my list of patrons, I should have two patrons, Scott and Jenny. And I'm going to go back to the lending section. I'm going to check out an item. So I'm going to search for Batman. I'm going to select this Batman book and I'm going to check that out to Scott. So I search for Scott, click him and place a checkout. Now, if I go to my list of checkouts, it's going to list all the checkouts that are available or out. If I want to check it back in or change the due date, I can do that from here. So I'm going to check that back in. The other thing we can do is we can place items on hold. So I'm going to place this item on hold for Jenny. And now if I try to check this item out, it's going to tell me this item has a hold on it. Do I really want to check it out to someone if it already has a hold? If I do, let's say I want to check it out to Jenny, I can make it available or I can cancel here. If I go to the hold section, we can see all the list of items that have been placed on hold. And I can either release that hold from here or I can check it out from here. So if Jenny came in and she said, I have a hold, I don't have to go through the process of checking out the book through the lending section. I can just go to the holds. I can search for the book. In this case, I'm going to search for Jenny, the patron, and then I'm going to check it out. Excellent. And then finally, in this rapid demo, let's take a look at publishing libraries. So a published library is a way to make your collections available to your patrons so that they can view it and browse it. In this case, I'm going to call it libib.org is going to be the name of this URL that I'm going to have. And before I can do anything, I got to make sure I add this URL. Excellent. So this URL is now available here. This is what I would share out with my patrons. And then I have a bunch of options as to how I want to display it, what collections I want to display. I want to publish my one collection that I have, the level of detail I want to display. I want to display a summary level of detail. And then I have a whole bunch of display options. Do I want to show what type of item it is? Like, is it a book? Is it a movie? Do I want to show a display bar? A search bar that will let patrons be able to search. Do I want to display the tags? Do I want to display if it's been checked out or not? And we just have a bunch of options here, as well as some theming options. So you can change your logo. You can add some links. We also have some setting options as to if we want to allow patrons to be able to self-checkout. So now if I go to the publish page, we're going to see my library and the collections that I've published. And this is what the patrons will see. And this is how patrons can interact with your published library. In our settings of the publish section is allow our patrons to place holds or to do self-checkouts directly from our published site. So I turned on those settings, and if I go back to my published site now, when I view an item, I'm given the option to check it out now. So if I'm a patron and I have this item in my hand and I'm in the library, I can go to this website, click checkout, click complete, and then I log in either with my email address and password or with a barcode ID and password. If you have any questions, please reach out to us at libib.com. If you'd like to view our full walkthrough, we'll leave a link in the description, and that will be a full tutorial on how Libib Pro works. Thank you.